سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا رسول الله محمد، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace and the blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I bear witness openly that there is no God worthy of our worship, our submission, our sincerity, our true love, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our time for his sake. My brothers and sisters in the three communities, the community of New Purichi, the community of Dunedin Masjid, the community of Tarpon Spring in Masjid al-Rahman, just wanted to welcome all of you and start my lecture and our time and our meeting by saying Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh to everyone. May Allah, wherever you are in, may Allah send his blessings and peace upon you. May Allah send his mercy upon all of you. May Allah shower all of you with his mercy and forgiveness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate your ranks on the day of judgment. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let you all enter Jannatul Firdaus. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Another Tuesday lecture. And alhamdulillah, since we are in the month of Rajab, and we are here, alhamdulillah ya rabbal alameen, to talk about one of the great, great topics, which is the night journey and the ascension, al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj. Al-Isra' wal-Mi'raj, this is the journey that Allah had honored the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah had blessed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with lots of details, inshallah, that we need to share with you when we talk about the night journey and the ascension. When we talk about this beautiful, beautiful journey to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I just wanted, before we move to the topic, inshallah, let me welcome our Imam, Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid, Imam Masjid al-Rahman in Tarpon Spring. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sayyidina. May Allah bless you, ameen ya rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khairan.
أمين يا رب العالمين. جزاك الله خيرا مولانا الشيخ، ربنا يحفظك يا رب ويبارك في عمرك، حياكم الله.
حياكم وبياكم شيخنا.
بارك الله فيكم، جزاكم الله خيرا. And actually it's a great time. We missed you last week and I know it's out of your control, but I just wanted to share to everyone that when you come, alhamdulillah, you give a different taste to the lecture, and really, really, we are missing you, Imam Jalal.
You are the sweetest taste, but I am the salty, so we make it together. Oh,
beautiful, beautiful taste, mashallah.
Jazakallah.
Jazakallah khairan, barakallahu feek. And actually, it's a, when we talk about the night journey and the ascension, that's one of the very important incidents that happened in the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we talk about the night journey and the ascension, actually it's one of the miracles that happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And of course, we will talk inshallah about the Quranic verses. We will talk about lots of details related to the night journey and the ascension. But let me welcome Imam Hisham, who joined us on Zoom right now. Assalamu alaikum, Imam Hisham.
حبيبي وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته، كيف حالك؟
يا مرحبا، يا مرحبا شيخنا الحبيب.
كله تمام؟
حفظك، جزاكم الله خيرا. My brothers and sisters, now we are good to go. And when we talk about the night journey and the ascension, this is one of the events, one of the miracles, one of the incidents that happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And actually we have a chapter named after the night journey, which is Suratul Isra. And Suratul Isra, Allah is talking about that miracle that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken from the sacred house, which is Al-Kaaba, Al-Masjid Al-Haram, to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. What is the significance of that? And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be honored by this journey. What is the purpose? What is the significance of that? And you know, the most also beneficial question, what is the most benefits, or what are the benefits for us as Muslims when we hear about the incident of the night journey and the ascension? Lots of questions, inshallah, we want to give the answers to. But before all of this, let us enjoy, as we enjoy every week, with the recitation of Imam Hisham about Surah, or portions from Surah Al-Isra, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Yes, Imam, barakallahu feek. Here is the microphone.
جزاكم الله خيرا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واصبر وما صبرك إلا بالله ولا تحزن عليهم ولا تكن في ضيق مما يمكرون. إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. واصبر وما صبرك إلا بالله ولا تحزن عليهم ولا تك في ضيق مما يمكرون. إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. إن الله مع الذين اتقوا الذين هم سنون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا إلى المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. وآتينا موسى الكتاب وجعلناه هدى بني إسرائيل ألا تتخذوا من دوني وكيلا.
لا الله الله الله
ذرية من حملنا مع نوح ذرية من حملنا مع نوح إنه كان عبدا شكورا. وآتينا موسى الكتاب وجعلناه هدى لبني إسرائيل ألا تتخذوا من دوني وكيلا. ذرية من حملنا مع نوح إنه كان عبدا شكورا. وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل في الكتاب لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين ولتعلن علوا كبيرا. صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله تبارك الله، جزاك الله خيرا. الله
الله
أكبر، ما شاء الله. What a beautiful recitation، ما شاء الله. That's actually the time that we purify our souls and our hearts through listening to the Quran. May Allah keep us always attached with the Quran. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. My brothers and sisters, the night journey. It is called Al-Isra' and the Ascension. It is called Al-Mi'raj. Actually, it's not one journey. Actually, two journeys that Allah had bestowed His favors upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make him to go to the night journey and the ascension. Rasulullah, to make it very simple for those who never heard about the night journey and the ascension. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the angel Jibreel to go and visit the seven skies and what is beyond the seven skies. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken from Al-Masjid Al-Haram, some narration said from his house, to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. That's the night journey. And then he was taken from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa up to the skies, where he met the prophets, the messengers, and he met them also in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that night had commanded the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his ummah after him with the salah. Allah gifted him the gift of salah. Lots of questions and lots of things we need to know about this incident. But now we come to that question that I wanted Imam Jalal, inshallah, to give us the answer. Why that Allah had favored the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the night journey? What happened before this incident? tell us about the circumstances before the incident of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj to understand the full picture of this miracle that happened to Rasulullah. Yes, our Imam.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين، سيدنا محمد، سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين، وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا رب تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، My dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome back to another Tuesday. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We're back to business with Allah عز وجل. Because of you, because this beautiful and wonderful faces, mashallah, Rabbil Alameen. Welcome, our brother Imam Ahmed, mashallah, may Allah bless you, and Imam Hisham Salam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Let me say in the beginning, Imam Ahmed, you know, when you hear brother or Sheikh, Fadilat Sheikh, Imam Muhammad Yahya and Imam Hisham Salam, when you hear both of them, they take you to another side, subhanallah al-azim. So even
To another
even
word, we actually that you
Allah.
taste the Quran differently.
So whatever I'm
Jazakallah
gonna
khair,
say,
brother.
mashallah, wallahi, mashallah
Jazakallah
al-azim.
khair.
This is the taste of the Quran. This is the reality. And tonight, because of the Isra and Mi'raj, you know, it is reality, and it will prove that the Quran is real, and it will prove that the Quran is real from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how that we're going to say it, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to put this moments and this minutes, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate your status, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, and makes us a better Muslims and a better believers. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. As usual, brother Imam Ahmed, he asked the hard questions, you know, for the Imams, which is okay, mashallah, Rabbil Alameen. So he said, why Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam?
You see, I keep the answer for me. That's why I keep myself at the end.
Mashallah al-Azim. Wallahi, you are our Imam, wallahi. May Allah bless you. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. And wallahi, my dear respected brothers and sisters, I said it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ahmed, you know, he do a lot, you know, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Imam Hisham, Imam Muhammad Yahya, Imam Abdul Min'im, Imam Abu Sa'd. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Ameen. We are all here, alhamdulillah. I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
Yeah, don't forget Imam Jalal.
Oh, Jazakallah khairan. Jazakallah khairan. Barakallah fikum, Shaykhna. So we are all, alhamdulillah Rabbil Ameen, in your service, in your service. And subhanallah, incidents happened, you know, like 2 3 days ago, on Thursday, when maybe on Friday, in Wednesday, you know, when a call came to me early in the morning, and I call Imam Ahmed, you know, it doesn't matter what he has or what I have, subhanallah al-azim, but we all in a service, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. And I, as usual, as we said, and always saying, you're most welcome. Wallahi, I'll be more than happy if you call me 3 a.m. even and say to me, I have a question or something, as also our brother Sheikh Ahmed and Sheikh Hisham Salam. May Allah bless all of you. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Now, let's back to the question that brother, our brother and our Imam, Imam Ahmed Ali, asked. What happened? In order to answer this question, we need to know what happened before the Isra, before the miracle of the Isra happening. What happened? The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, alayhi salatu wasalam, he lost his, I'm not going to say his wife, but he lost Khadija. And you know who is Khadija? Khadija is the wife of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Khadija is the supporter to the Prophet of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. Khadija is the given person. Khadija is the understanding. Khadija is the care. Khadija is the love. Khadija is the mother of all his children except for one, which is Ibrahim. Khadija is a lot. And suddenly the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lost her. She died. It was great sorrow in his heart, you know, to lose the one who protect him, the one who support him at this life, the one who gives him everything, the one who she understand everything about the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا رب العالمين. So when he lost her, it was a great sorrow in his heart, because she the first one, she the first lady at the time of the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم that Allah عز وجل talk, you know, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى send to her peace, meaning salam to Khadijah. Peace and blessing. May Allah be pleased with her. Ameen, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. No one ever, never, subhanAllah Al-Azim, being same like our beloved, wonderful, grateful mom, Khadija. SubhanAllah Al-Azim. And what she did to Islam, and what she did for the, what she did for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what she did to Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. A lot of talks, you know, if we talk about Khadija, you know me, I love my mom Khadija. Wallahi, subhanallah al-azim, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal in the day of judgment, inshallah, Rabbil Ameen, to give me the opportunity, you know, to kiss her hand. I said to her, and I will say to her, inshallah, Rabbil Ameen, thank you for everything. And she died, and she did not see any victory, subhanallah al-azim, to Islam. And she died. And she gave everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then after that, Allahu Akbar. After that, he lost his other supporter, other protection here at, you know, at this world. He lost Abu Talib, which is his uncle, Abu Talib, which he lived with him for 17 years. Lived with him, and he loves him. He loves him a lot, subhanallah al-azim. And another hit, that what happened? That Abu Talib died and he is non-Muslim, not in the status of Islam. And it was a big, big hit for the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. How come? You know, he is his uncle, subhanallah al-azim. You know, it's one after one after one. Now he doesn't have two of the most supporter. His wife Khadija, you know, may Allah be pleased with her. Then his uncle Abu Talib, subhanallah al-azim. And moreover, he did not just like stay. He said, okay, I will go to At-Ta'if. And when he went to At-Ta'if, you know what happened? They humiliated him. And when he went there to At-Ta'if, he has a great hope that they're going to accept his da'wah. More than that, they will talk to the people of Quraysh. You know, and everybody gonna accept Islam. This is what he's thinking. Peace and blessing be upon him, because he always thinking positive. And there is no any negativity of the personality of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But this is not what happened. Nobody accept even in a Ta'if. So Allahu Akbar, ya akhi, you know, for hate after hate after hate. But you know what? This is not the first time. Do you remember Surah Al-Duha? When Allah Azza wa Jalla said to Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when the Jewish people and this believer, they said to him, you know, your Lord already stay away from you, there is no more revelation coming to you, then Allah Azza wa Jalla give him this treatment, wadduha wallay wadduha wadduha wallayli idha saja ma wadda'aka rabbuka wa ma qala. Your Lord doesn't, you know, they take himself away from you, no worry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep saying to him, أَلَمْ يَجِدَكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. You know, and Allah Azza wa Jal keep saying to him that he is not alone. Allah will not leave him. Subhanallah al-Azim. But this time is more, because one hit after hit after hit, you know, keep, you know, to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the reality of the Quran. And this is proof. You know, the Isra and Mi'raj, it is proof that the Quran is real. It is proof. Why? Because what happened to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and here is the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away. This journey, this beautiful journey, it is a treatment to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Allah azza wa jal saying to him, and it is an invitation, as our prophet, our brother Imam Ahmad Ali said, that it is an invitation from Allah azza wa jal. So it is treatment to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not worry. You know, if you lost your supporter here at this dunya, and if you lost your protection at this world, so Allah Azza wa Jal with you. And you know the most important thing, that innaka la tahdi man ahbabt, walakin Allah yahdi man yasha. You did not guide whom you love, but Allah Azza wa Jal, he is the one who guide who he will. You know, with the willing of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. This is why the Prophet, Allah Azza wa Jal chose Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام because he is the last messenger, you know, and he chose him in order to conceal, in order to say to him, do not worry. Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala with you, you know, innaka bi'ayunina, you are in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters, it is a great journey. Inshallah, Rabbil Ameen, I'm going to leave the space to my brother Imam Hisham, then after that Imam Ahmad Ali, to talk more and more about this beautiful and wonderful journey and to prove again that the Quran is real and the Quran is reality, and it came to, you know, for the incident happened, you know, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. I back to you, my Imam, Imam Ahmad, inshallah.
Shaykhana, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, Allahumma ameen. So my brothers and sisters, here are what Imam Jalal had mentioned. The circumstances weren't good at all. It was so tragic with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was so hard, trials after trials. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his chest was so constricted, was so tight, to the point that the verses that Imam Hisham had recited right before Allah is telling us about al-Isra, Allah is concealing the heart of the Prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, be patient and accept the destiny of Allah. Like Allah is giving him the condolences regarding Khadija and the loss of Khadija and his uncle. And now there was a night, في ليلة صفت سماؤها ورق ماؤها وطاب هواؤها في ليلة اتصل فيها نور السماء بأرض الصحراء جاءت الدعوة من الله عن طريق الأمين جبريل وإذا بالأمين جبريل يجوب الآفاق ويطوي بأجنحته السبع الطباق وينزل على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها النبي أنت الآن مدعو لزيارة السماء فالداعي هو الله والمدعو هو رسول الله وحامل الدعوة جبريل عليه السلام. So there was a specific night when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the invitation to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And from that time, the night journey had started. I cannot talk about the night journey. That is the mission of our Imam, Imam Hisham, who can tell us more about the night journey. Please, here's the microphone, Imam.
جزاكم الله خيرا حبيبنا الغالي، بارك الله فيك، منكم نتعلم دوما. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق وحبيب الحق وسيد المرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه أجمعين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الملك الحق المبين، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وإمامنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفي الله جل وعلا من الخلق وخليله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله رب العالمين على يديه المباركتين الغمة. صلاة وسلام عليك سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك ومن سار على الخطى واتبع الهدى إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him, thank him, seek his help and forgiveness. Allah تبارك وتعالى, as he mentioned in Surah Al-Isra, Allah تبارك وتعالى wanted to please the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, as our Imam Jalal, may Allah be pleased with him, Allahumma ameen. As he said, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala tested the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, first the death of Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha, mother of the believers, and the death of Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and the people who refused the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wanted to please and to make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam happy sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. So here the incident of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. And when we call about al-Isra, the night journey, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, as we know, commanded this incident to happen during night. And here is a sign from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and a message from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. in which we call the when you want something from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, when you want Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to accept your dua, just wait until the night starts and then start your dua, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will accept your dua, as he used to do sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to pray all night, and when mother of the believers Khadija or Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha used to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, why do you pray all the night and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has forgiven your sins? لِمَا تُصَلِّي وَلِمَا هَذَا وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. فَكَانَ رَدُّ الرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam told mother of the believers Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha that he wanted to be a thankful servant of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So here is the prize from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. As long as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam increased his worship to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala during the night, here is the journey of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and happens to him during the night in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The journey of Isra started from the holy mosque or the sacred mosque Al-Kaaba and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, which is in Mecca. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wanted to show us that there is an important thing, which is Al-Kaaba. Al-Kaaba is the sacred mosque, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Al-Masjid Al-Haram. It's the first house of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala that was built on this land. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وضع للناس للذي ببكة مبارك. So the first house of worship and it was built by the angels while its foundations were laid up by Ibrahim and Ismail عليهما السلام. So day and night, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, people circle around the Kaaba, and when they stop, the angels take over. Muslims from all over the world come to the Kaaba and they face the Kaaba during their prayers, their 5 daily prayers. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. Then turn your face to the direction of the sacred mosque, which is al-Masjid al-Haram. So this teaches us as Muslims the importance of the sacred mosque in the sight of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, which indicates the unity and the tawheed of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And then the destination of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And when we mention al-Masjid al-Aqsa, of course we remember our issue there and what happens during these times. So we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to free al-Masjid al-Aqsa, Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen, and ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help and support our brothers in Palestine, ameen, ameen ya rabbil alameen. So there is also a major event which indicates the transfer of leadership to the Muslim Ummah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said in the Quran, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. You, meaning the true believers of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, are the best of people ever raised up for mankind. You enjoin al-ma'ruf, which is tawheed, and all the Islam has ordained, and forbid al-munkar, which is shirk and disbelief, and you believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The second point here is Palestine itself. It's a blessed land, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, which contains al-Masjid al-Aqsa, the first qibla of the Muslimin. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala told us, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam told us about the importance of al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Also, it was the location where the Isra of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam occurred. It was home for the most of the prophets, Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Lut, Sayyidina Ya'qub, Sayyidina Yahya, and Sayyidina Zakariya alayhim wa ala nabiyyina afdalu salati wa salam. And most of the prophets were buried there in Palestine, as the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. Also, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala told us that this place and this land is blessed by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So we have to teach our children and our next generations about the importance of Masjid al-Aqsa and the importance of Palestine to make them feel that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has chosen them among the nations to have this sacred place, which is al-Masjid al-Aqsa and Palestine. Also, in al-Masjid al-Aqsa, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did a very important thing. He صلى الله عليه وسلم led the prayers and behind him were all the prophets as Allah تبارك وتعالى told us in the Quran and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us in the Sunnah. And here is another message from Allah تبارك وتعالى. This event was important and it indicates the elevated status of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم and the elevated rank of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and also the توحيد of his message صلوات الله عليه وسلامه and all the previous messengers. They all have the same origin. They all came to their people just to worship Allah تبارك وتعالى and never associate anyone with Allah تبارك وتعالى. They all have the same purpose and the same goal, which is the complete submission to Allah تبارك وتعالى. As Allah سبحانه mentioned in the Quran, إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. So they followed one another until the message was completed by the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Also in the hadith, he صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the prophets before me are like a nearly finished house, which is missing one plug. And people would keep saying, if not only for that plug, then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I'm like that plug. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم completed and finished the message from Allah تبارك وتعالى, which started from Adam عليه السلام to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. So we ask Allah تبارك وتعالى to free our masjid, al-masjid al-Aqsa, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen, and to help us to pray in al-masjid al-Aqsa soon, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen. And we ask him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help and support our brothers in Palestine. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Back to our Imam Ahmad, jazakumullahu khayra, wa taqabbal Allahu minna wa minkum salih al-a'mal.
Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullahu khayran, our imams. And actually, the time, as I'm watching right now, 7 minutes for the adhan of Isha, and then we still have the dua. Inshallah, we will pass this time the dua for Imam Jalal. So, because we missed him last time, you remember, Imam?
Yes.
Okay. So now I just wanted to, because actually the al-Mi'raj itself, the ascension journey, it's a very long journey. We cannot cover the whole journey in 5 minutes, but I just wanted to tell you the whole purpose from the night journey and the ascension, because the ascension had started from Jerusalem, from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us victory and liberate Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. But the journey had started from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was using a special transportation, which, as we know, Al-Buraq. So Al-Buraq, that's a special transportation, came from the other side of the world, from the hereafter, from the Jannah. Sometimes some people said it's from Jannah, but it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah sent that transportation, the let's call the animal that was carrying the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the Sunnah of Rasulullah, we understand that he wasn't the first one. He wasn't the first one using Al-Buraq as a transportation. All the prophets and the messengers had used the same transportation before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But two things I want to share with you. How Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was welcomed in the skies. Actually, he met some of the prophets and the messengers. So he went to the first sky. I'm going to say that only for the first sky. Then, you know, it's repeated on the other skies as well. So the first sky, he went, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with Jibreel alayhi salam. And Jibreel alayhi salam knocked the door, the gate of the first sky. So now we understand that there is a specific gate for each and every sky. And he knocked the door. And they said, those who are inside, they said, who is knocking? He said, Jibreel. And they said, who is with you? He said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they opened the gates. They said, marhaban, welcome to the messenger of Allah. And he met on the first sky, Adam alayhi salam. And Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam said, marhaban bil ibn al-salih wal-nabi al-salih. He said, welcome to the righteous son and the righteous prophet and the messenger of Allah. So Sayyidina Adam welcomed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. On the second sky, he met and he was welcomed by Yahya, John, and Isa alayhi salam. And the third sky, he was welcomed by Yusuf alayhi salam. The fourth one, he was welcomed by Idris alayhi salam. The fifth one, he was welcomed by Harun, Aaron, the brother of Moses alayhi salam. And the sixth sky, he was welcomed by Moses himself. Then the seventh sky, he was welcomed by the close servant of Allah, Khalilur Rahman, Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam give us all the details. I can tell you all the details about the ascension journey. What did he see? He saw some snapshots from the heavens, from Jannah, some snapshots from the hellfire. He saw some people are getting punished. He saw some people are getting rewarded and honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he gave specific explanation for what reason was the punishment and for what reason was the reward from Allah. Lots of things happened during the ascension, but one of the details that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us about, that Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam was in the seventh sky next to a sacred house also, which is called Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. So what we understand, as we have a sacred house, which is the Kaaba on earth, the angels of Allah have the same, almost the same sacred house. It is called Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have seen Ibrahim alayhi salam leaning his back to the wall of the sacred house Al-Ma'mur. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that that sacred house is so big, is so vast, so wide, to the point that every single day 70,000 angels of Allah are entering to the house, to the sacred house, as if they are doing Hajj or Umrah, visiting that sacred house, Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. And what I see so interesting and ironic when it comes to the number, the vast number of the angels of Allah, that they are not allowed to go back to enter again. So every day you have 70,000 of the angels. That gives you a little background about how many are the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah went to a place and he said, أَسْمَعُ فِيهِ صَفِيرَ الْأَقْلَامِ. He went to a place beyond the seven skies, beyond something I mentioned before. It is called Sidratul Muntaha. The rough translation, which I don't think it's a fair translation, the very end, the very end, like barrier, a place where it is Muntaha for everything. That's the end for everything. And I told you before, the angels of Allah cannot cross Sidratul Muntaha. Our souls cannot cross Sidratul Muntaha. No one, no prophet, no messenger was allowed to cross Sidratul Muntaha and to pass Sidratul Muntaha. And I said two things. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was allowed to pass Sidratul Muntaha. And the other thing is the da'watul madhloom. What is my evidence? What is my evidence? Da'watul madhloom can penetrate Sidratul Muntaha. Because we have a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam about the dua of the oppressed one, that he will say his dua and that dua will go around the throne of Allah buzzing like the bees, until Allah says, وَعِزَّكِ وَجَلَالِي لَأَنْصُرَنَّكِ وَلَوْ بَعْدَ حِينَ. I swear by my majesty and my power that I will give you victory even after a while. Then Allah bestowed His ni'mah upon the Prophet Muhammad when Allah had a conversation with Rasulullah. Allah Himself welcomed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a place that no human being ever had reached to. Then Allah gifted him the salah, the pillar of salah, and that tells you about how great is salah is in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I see the time, and then I see the time for Isha. Lots of details what I would like to tell with, to share with you about the mercy of Allah in reducing the number of salah. What was the reaction of the people of Quraysh after Rasulullah had finished the night journey and ascension? But actually, there is no time for this as we came to the Adhan of Isha. Now I will pass the microphone to Imam Jalal, inshallah, Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid, to give us the last portion of this session, which is the dua. May Allah accept his dua. Allahumma ameen. Yes, our Imam.
Ameen, Ya Rabbi. May Allah bless you. Ameen, Ya Rabbi Al-Ameen. Jazakum Allah khairan. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا رب تسليما كثيرا. اللهم ارزقنا خير هذه الليلة وخير ما فيها وخير ما بعدها إلى يوم الدين. اللهم يا رب العالمين اهدنا يا رب في من هديت، وعافنا يا رب في من عافيت. اللهم ارزقنا رزقا حلالا طيبا مباركا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا، ارحم يا رب موتانا، اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا، اجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، اجعلنا يا رب هادين مهديين، راضين مرضيين، اغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا، وقد نسينا وأخطأنا يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت قلوبنا ونفوسنا وعقولنا وأبصارنا وأجسادنا وضمائرنا يا رب تقواها، وزكها يا رب أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم إننا ضعفاء مساكين جئنا إليك، ولا حول لنا يا رب، والحول والقوة بك، منك إلى ومنك وإليك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم ارحم شهداء المسلمين يا رب العالمين. يا رب كن مع غزة وأهل غزة يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضاهم، داوي يا رب جرحاهم. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم قهم شر هذا البرد. اللهم قهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم أنت الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. اللهم إنا نسألك وندعوك، وأنت الله، أنت رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين، كلنا ولا تكن علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك وأنعم على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
جزاكم الله خيرا. I want to thank
بارك الله
all
فيك.
of you actually. جزاكم الله خيرا إمام هشام، جزاكم الله خيرا إمام
جزاكم الله
جلال.
خير. آمين.
بارك الله فيك my brothers and sisters. جزاكم الله خيرا. I cannot thank you enough for your commitments and your actually the great presence and the great response to the invitation to come to the Zoom. May Allah reward you for your coming, for your sacrifice. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. بارك الله فيكم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
وعليكم
وبركاته.
السلام ورحمة الله
وعليكم السلام.
وبركاته.